From this lecture of analog communication, we are going to start modulation process of the SSB-SC modulated signal. Single sideband suppressed carrier signal or SSB-SC signal is consist of either of two sidebands, namely upper sideband or lower sideband signal. Based on these two sidebands, SSB-SC modulated signal can be classified as upper sideband SSB-SC modulated signal and lower sideband SSB-SC modulated signal. Graphically, upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal can be shown as equation of the upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal is ST is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FMT minus AM into AC divided by 2 sin 2 pi FMT into sin 2 pi FCT. Now, if we take AM into AC divided by 2 common from the equation and apply the formula of cos A plus B is equal to cos A cos B minus sin A sin B, then it can be written as upper sideband SSBSC modulated signal is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. And again, lower sideband SSBSC modulated signal can be shown as the equation of the lower sideband SSBSC modulated signal is given by AM into AC divided by 2 into cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FMT plus AM into AC divided by 2 sin 2 pi FMT into sin 2 pi FCT. Again, if we take AM into AC divided by 2 common from the equation and apply the formula of cos A minus B is equal to cos A cos B plus sin A sin B, then the following equation can be written as lower sideband SSBSC modulated signal is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T. There are basically three types of modulation process that can be used for the generation of the SSBSC modulated signal, and they are frequency discrimination method or filter method, phase discrimination method or phase shift method, and finally Weaver's method or third method. In this lecture, we will see how the frequency discrimination method or filter method can be used for the generation of the SSBSC modulated signal. Among all the methods, one of the straightforward methods for the generation of the SSBSC modulated signal is this frequency discrimination method. As the name suggests, in this method, a SSBSC modulated signal is generated by filtering out dsb-sc modulated signal with the help of a bandpass filter. We have already seen what are the drawbacks when you try to generate SSBSC modulated signal by using bandpass filter in the last lecture. In this lecture, we will simply revise the method with the proper diagrams and everything. In this method of the SSBSC generation, the dsb-sc modulator is used for the generation of the dsb-sc modulated signal, which contains both the sidebands, and output of this modulator, which is the dsb-sc modulated signal, will be given as an input to the bandpass filter in order to generate ssb-sc modulated signal based on the condition provided to the bandpass filter. Let us see the block diagram for the frequency discrimination method of ssb-sc generation. This ssb-sc generation method is a series combination of dsb-sc modulator and bandpass filter. At first, message signal MT and the carrier signal CT are given as an input to the product modulator for the generation of the dsb-sc signal, which contains both upper and lower sideband. dsb-sc modulated signal in this method can be generated by using an ordinary product modulator or a balanced modulator. Here we have used a product modulator for the generation of the dsb-sc modulated signal. Output of this product modulator is passed through a bandpass filter. The bandpass filter allows to generate either a upper sideband signal or a lower sideband SSBSC modulated signal depending upon bandwidth of the bandpass filter. So, this bandpass filter is responsible for the proper generation of the SSBSC modulated signal. Based on the passband, this bandpass filter can either select upper sideband or lower sideband. This selection process becomes pretty difficult when the edges of the bandpass filter are not that sharp or bandpass filter has poor selectivity. This problem of the bandpass filter is discussed at length in the lecture of drawbacks of the generation of SSBSC modulated signal by using the bandpass filter. Click on the I button and watch the lecture to understand why it is difficult to generate SSBSC modulated signal properly by using this bandpass filter. Now, let's see the mathematical analysis for the frequency discrimination method for the generation of the SSBSC modulated signal. Let's say message signal MT is equal to AM cos 2 pi FMT, carrier signal CT is equal to AC cos 2 pi FCT. Output of the product modulator is the product of message signal MT and the carrier signal CT. So the product modulator output ST is equal to MT into CT. By putting the value of MT and CT in the equation, ST can be written as ST is equal to AM cos 2 pi FMT into AC cos 2 pi FCT. Rearrange the equation and multiply and divide ST by 2, then ST can be written as AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FMT into cos 2 pi FCT. Now we know that 2 cos A cos B is equal to cos A minus B plus cos A plus B. If we apply the formula in the following equation, then it can be written as ST is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. Now multiply AM into AC by 2 with both the terms, then ST can be written as ST is equal to AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T plus AM into AC divided by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T. Now this is the equation of the dsb-sc modulated signal, and this dsb-sc modulated signal contains both the sidebands. This AM into AC by 2 cos 2 pi FC minus FM into T is the equation of the lower sideband, and AM into AC by 2 cos 2 pi FC plus FM into T is the equation of the upper sideband, which we have already seen at the beginning of the lecture. Now this dsb-sc modulated signal is given as an input to the bandpass filter. The bandpass filter, which has two cutoff frequencies as upper cutoff frequency and lower cutoff frequency, by selecting this upper and lower cutoff frequency of the bandpass filter, we can generate both types of SSB-SC modulated signal. Here, several types of bandpass filter like LC filter, crystal filter and mechanical filter can be used for the generation of the SSB-SC modulated signal. Among them, mechanical filters are most commonly used when the working frequency is over 1 MHz. When we are working with the low frequency, then we should try to avoid the use of bandpass filter and apply other methods for the generation of the SSB-SC modulated signal, because the modulation circuit of the SSB-SC becomes large when we try to generate SSB-SC modulated signal by using the bandpass filter in the low frequency. Now let's see how to modulate speech signal by using this filter method. In the field of communication, the usable voice frequency band ranges from approximately 300 to 3400 Hz. So in the frequency domain, this speech signal can be represented by, in the frequency domain, this speech signal will have replicas after 300 Hz. For the dsb-sc modulation of this speech signal, we have to shift this speech signal to the frequency fc in the positive x-axis and to the frequency minus fc in the negative x-axis, and the amplitude of the shifter signal will be half compared to the amplitude of the speech signal. This FC is the frequency of the carrier signal. Now, as you can see, there is a difference of 600 Hz between the two sidebands. Now, to select either of the sidebands, we need to use bandpass filter. If we are using practical filter, which does not have a sharp cutoff like ideal filter, we will still manage to recover either of the sidebands, as there is a gap of 600 Hz between the two sidebands, or we can select upper sideband without selecting any part of the lower sideband when we are passing only the upper sideband through the bandpass filter, and vice versa. This bandpass filter should select upper sidebands if we want upper sideband SSB-SC modulated speech signal, and this bandpass filter should select lower sidebands if we want lower sideband SSB-SC modulated speech signal. Generally, in order to avoid any interference from the unwanted band, this bandpass filter here should be able to suppress that particular unwanted band. And this suppression of the unwanted band must be done by at least 40 dB in amplitude. Achieving a suppression of 40 dB in amplitude is still possible in the lower carrier frequency, but if the carrier frequency is higher, let's say over 1 MHz, then we cannot achieve 40 dB in amplitude suppression with a gap of 600 Hz between the two sidebands. Then we cannot use this process of SSB-SC generation, and we need to make some changes to the circuit in order to achieve SSB-SC modulation of this speech signal. So rather than using one stage, we will use two stages of modulation for obtaining SSB-SC modulated speech signal with a carrier frequency over 1 MHz. And we will see this method of modulation in the next lecture. Now let us see what are the limitations of this SSB-SC modulation by using filter method. For this modulation, message signal MT must have a very little or low frequency content. This modulation process is not possible for video signals as there is no gap between upper and lower sideband signal, which makes the separation of sidebands impossible. That's why this method cannot be used for broadcasting purposes. Passband of the bandpass filter must be equal to or greater than desired sideband frequency spectrum of the DSB-SC modulated signal, such that it does not select other sideband. Frequency component of the message signal must be less than the carrier frequency FC, otherwise it will be very difficult to design the bandpass filter for this process. Required bandpass filter with high quality factor to ensure greater selectivity and narrow bandwidth, which is essential for the proper generation of the SSBSC modulator signal. Bandpass filter with high selectivity increases the cost of generation of the SSBSC modulator signal. That's all for this lecture. If you have any doubts regarding this lecture, then you may ask it in the comment section. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. See you in the next one.